lost my beautiful wife to a witness. Hey, hey, Mama, Mama, hey, Blessed Mary, Mama, you want me not to be careful about a beautiful woman. But I did not listen. Even Madame Teresa, late Madame Teresa, she called me like a son. Don't marry Bianca, that Bianca will not make a good wife to you. That Bianca is not a wife material. But my urge for beautiful women blinded my eyes. Look at my wife, she's not sleeping with different kind of men, just in the name of work. And I was so happy to see her coming home today so early. I don't know how I'm expecting this. Oh my God. No. She will not kill me. And I will not die prematurely. I will overcome this. God.
Just woman. Her heart's filled with greed and wickedness. She cares only for herself. And do whatever she please with recklessness. She lies, she cheats, and hurts anyone that stands in her way. But in the end, there'll always be a price to pay. Oh, the just woman, her heart straight and steady, her light shines so bright. She's always ready to stand for justice and lend a helping hand. She's truly grand, all for each call.
Hi.
Hi.
Good morning.
Good morning.
My name is Oscar.
Sharon.
Nice to meet you.
Same here.
So you live around here?
Not too far from here.
Oh, okay. So do you often walk out on this road?
Well, a couple of times a week.
Oh, that's great. Right. You look good.
Thank you.
So what do you do for a living?
Well, nothing, really.
Nothing? Sorry, nothing.
I just completed my NYC and I'm job hunting.
Oh, job hunting. I see. Okay, I work with Richmore Group of companies here.
Nice. And good for you.
Yeah, I'm close to the MD.
Okay.
I can talk to him on your behalf. What did you study, please?
Business administration.
Business admin. Oh, that's good. So I can talk to him on your behalf.
Really?
That's okay. Yeah, I can. Yeah, I can. Okay. Please, let me have your number so I can...
Oh, sure. Sharon.
Yeah. Yeah, Sharon. Yes. I remember. I'll just save it. So like I said, I'm close to the MD. I can talk to him on your behalf. And whatever he says, I'll give you a call.
Okay.
Is that okay?
Sure.
All right.
Thank you.
Have a nice day.
You too. Nice morning.
All right.
Why did you bring me here?
Don't you like this place? This is where I have the best restaurants in town. I mean, I like the food. It tastes really nice.
It just appeared to the MD. Why would you want to spend your month's salary just to please me?
Well, I might just be a PA, thank you very much. But I know rich people. I also know the owner of the restaurant. So whatever we're having here has been paid for. Yeah.
So because you know the owner of the restaurant, then miraculously everything we're having is paid for. I don't understand.
Well, like I said, I know a lot of people. I know rich people. Yeah.
Seriously?
Mm-hmm. Sharon, you've had a stressful day at the office, so I actually brought you here to have a nice time. All right? Enjoy your food.
I earn more than you. I could still take care of this.
It's been taken care of, I told you.
Woman, her heart straight and steady, her light shines so bright. She's always ready to stand for justice and lend a helping hand. She's truly grand. Oporiche Kobo, Oporiche Kobo. She's a just woman, Oporiche Kobo. How you lying it.
But my biggest problem is how to convince my father she's the one I want to spend the rest of my life with. That's my challenge. How do I make them understand? Especially my dad. And mom too.
Tell me, who is he?
Mom, who is who?
Cut the pretense. You are lost in thought, smiling and laughing all to yourself. Who is this guy?
Mom.
I know it must be a guy.
Mom, please, can you just get off my back? Leave me alone. What is it?
I cannot get off your back to continue wallowing in thoughts. Tell me, my daughter. Acharugo, my angel. Who is this guy that has captured your heart?
Mom, you're still insisting.
Yes, I know. I know someone is there.
Well, Mom,
don't
just
worry.
Like to gossip. What is
it? Speak out! My daughter is in love. I can see it in your eyes.
Mom, please. I don't know if I'm in love, but
I'll tell you about him when the time is right. But just know that,
I agree. I surrender. I surrender. All I know is that my daughter is in love.
Mom,
and
please,
this is the right time.
Stop.
You know what? Aya, eat your food.
You're making me shy.
Don't. Just eat your food.
But that was what I was about to do when you just came here and started talking about guy. What guy? Did you say guy?
As if. I'm a kid.
Mom, do you think it's flower love that you used to do back in the day? Please just leave me alone. Please. Your husband is not here.
But I've been able to find out what is going secretly. Eat your food.
Please,
Sharon.
You know what? I need my space.
Please, no problem.
Please. I need my space.
No problem. I agree. Your brother called.
Oh. I miss him. I'll call him.
He even said that he will call you.
Really?
Yeah.
You see, the twin thing. The twin connection.
Well, don't tell me that. That is why he's a lie.
Mom, I was thinking about my brother.
No! He's a lie!
Am I cooking again tonight? What have I done to myself? Chai, is this my cross to carry?
Daddy,
yeah.
Are you the one cooking again tonight? I thought your wife is back.
Yeah. Chessy, please. She's still your mother, okay?
Dad, I hate her. I hate her with passion.
Chessy, stop complaining. Stop it.
I don't know why God gave me such a woman as a mother. Why is she doing all this? Why?
Your mother is tired. She's tired.
Oh, Dad. Come on, keep on covering up for her. I hope we are not going to eat these noodles this night because I will not eat it, let alone eat.
My heart. What have I done to myself? Is it a sin to marry a beautiful woman? What my wife does these days is just working, being a staff to reach more group of company. But it's not fair. It's totally not fair.
Our hearts filled with greed and wickedness. She cares only for herself. But she pleased with recklessness. She lies, she cheats, and hurts anyone that stands in her way. But in the end, there'll always be a price to pay.
Oh, the just woman, her heart straight and steady. She's always ready to stand for justice and lend a helping hand. She's truly grand, a Porichi Kobo. A Porichi Kobo. She's a just woman, a Porichi Kobo.
How you lay your bed is how you lie on it. You sow is what you reap. How you lay your bed is how you lie on it. What you sow is what you reap.
Oh, just woman, her heart straight and steady.
So steady.
Life shines so bright. Oh. She's always.
Hope is not what I'm thinking. Hey, Bianca, pregnancy? I don't even know who is responsible.
She knows the problem. You promised me a promotion, and up to now, you've not fulfilled your promise.
Yes, it's true that I promised you a promotion, but you have to be a little bit patient with that promotion. It will surely come.
I don't have time. I need this promotion as quickly as possible.
Well, I understand how desperate you are and how eager you can't wait to grab this promotion. You see, after the promotion of Mrs. Bianca, the MDA hasn't been cool with things around here. So I will advise we take it on the slow. I mean, by the time things calm down, I'm going to hit the desk again with promotion list, like boom. It's going to start happening again.
I don't get it. Why is the MDA so nosy about her promotion?
Well, I actually am not supposed to be telling you this, but you know you're so dear into my heart. Mrs. Bianca isn't due for that promotion. As a matter of fact, it's I and Mr. Jeffrey that has to work on that for that promotion to come through.
You mean Mrs. Bianca is sleeping with you and the manager? Holy Moses. What is going on in this company? How did I even get myself in this mess?
What do you mean?
I think I'm pregnant. I've not seen my monthly flu for 2 months now.
Well, you're familiar with the saying that what goes around comes around, and it's no longer that way. Nowadays, what goes around goes from there. I mean, why don't you just go ahead and take care of it as usual? Why are you making it look as if it's a big deal or probably want to start celebrating you or something? Come on, handle it, you're a big girl.
Listen to me. I will never have any abortion again. I mean, this is the fifth abortion I'm having in 2 years. I won't do that.
So what would you have me do if I may ask you? Well, I think that's the only way around this whole thing. Except there's other way that you want me to know. Then you go ahead and tell me.
It's high time you take responsibility for your actions.
Mr. Turbulence Remover.
Mr. Turbulence Remover.
You are just a deceiver.
A deceiver.
You are a turbulence giver. And not
a turbulence remover.
Do you realize you're talking to me?
Mr. Turbulence. Of course I know who I'm talking to.
You are just a deceiver.
A deceiver.
Soon your game will be over. And you will become
Mr. Turbulence.
This woman is so hot.
Thank you.
You know, I want to say something to you.
And go ahead, Amalie.
I'm pregnant.
You are what?
Yes, I've been feeling funny and I've been vomiting, so having morning sickness, and I checked myself out. I'm pregnant.
Please, button up. Button up your top, Annie. I am not doing it again.
Why? Because I said I'm pregnant? You didn't ask me who is responsible.
Why would I do that? How can I ask a married woman who is responsible for a pregnancy? Of course, your husband is the father of your unborn baby.
It's not my husband. I've not met with my husband for like in a long time. We've not had sex in a long time. So it is not my husband.
You stopped sleeping with your husband. Well, in that case, Edmund should be responsible for the seed you are carrying.
It is not for Edmund. It is yours.
Don't say it again. Don't say it again.
What exactly are you talking about? Huh? You think I don't know that I'm not even know who has been sleeping with you in this office? You think I didn't know that you've been sleeping with the manager as well?
Look up, supervisor. You are the only one responsible for my pregnancy.
You know what? At this point, I think I'm done with this conversation. If you don't mind, can you leave my office this minute? I have work to do.
You lie! I am going nowhere. In fact, you have to get a towing van to tow me out of this office. Rubbish. So when you were climbing me, you didn't know I might get pregnant. Hey, hey.
Just hold it there, hold it there.
When I was climbing you, I didn't know it was going to lead to this rubbish. Is that what you just said right now? Were you not enjoying it? I'm asking you. Were you not enjoying it while we're having it? You enjoyed it, and I did. Including Mr. Jeffrey, the manager. So we both enjoyed it. As he treat us, he did pain them. As he did pain them, he did sweet us. But in this case, it was sweeting everybody. So put yourself together and get out of my office.
He go pain you, Dad. Because you know what? I am not having any abortion. I am not. What I want now is marriage. Oga, you go marry me. You will marry me. What I want now is marriage. Hey, you will marry me. When you are done joking, you can talk to me.
Anyway, I was trying to help you cry because obviously you're hung out of marriage, but I'm setting you as well in terms of commitment. Listen, you don't talk about marriage with me because I have a woman in the house who is rightly pregnant for me. And as I'm talking to you right now, I'm going to be a father soon.
You see your life? You see how you've messed up your life?
Point of correction, my life is not messed up. Well, when the Bible said, go into the world and multiply, who do you think the Bible was referring to? It's I, Edmund, and I'm so multiplying into the world, and I'm going to be a father soon.
You're wicked. You are a wicked man. You are a beast. You mean you have a girl you got pregnant all this while, and you keep telling me to open my legs? Climb me up and then do whatever you want with my body.
Were you forced to get that done?
Look, see, I decrease you. I don't know, man. You see this matter, eh? We will take it to the board. We'll die here. You see me and you. You don't marry me, finish. Wait. I go show you how be worried, gay, then Chris.
Are you threatening me? Are you threatening me? It's like you've not realized that beneath this man, there's a trenches king living in here. If I show you my bubble last speech, you will like her. If I reveal my bubble last speech, give you, you go wrong. You're mad.
Okay, I never see Chris. Now you're mad. You see, we go show ourselves. See, I'm worried, girl. I don't get shame.
She's, I'm going to bust your head for this.
You don't reach out to Chris.
I'm going to bust your head for this.
Oh, you carry that one. I've been worried, girl. I hope
I'll bust your head now.
You know what? I am taking it easy with you because you're in the office. If you try this with me outside, I will surprise you. I'm telling you.
No futurity. You must marry me.
Get out of the
house. I'm not going anywhere. You must marry me.
You're shouting. Listen to me, Bianca. You can't push pregnancy on me. Look for somebody who is responsible for it. After all, while I was on leave, we were both having it.
Jeffrey, this pregnancy is 2 months old. I've been doing abortions, series of abortions, and my daughter has warned me not to even do another one. Because if I try it, my life will end. I will just die.
You mean you have been having abortions for Edmund? Well, take it to him. If he rejects it, then take it to your husband at home.
I just told you now, you're not deaf. That's my husband and I, we've not had any intimacy for a very long time. Like, did you hear what I said? Did you hear me?
So you were busy punishing an innocent man while sharing it in the office.
How am I even sure if Timothy and other guys?
There's something wrong with you. Are you mad or something?
Bianca, you slapped me.
Yes, and I will slap you again.
You're fired.
Fired by you. You're fired. Imbecile speaking, listen to me. This baby is yours. You do not have a choice. You don't want to tell me that. If I snap my fingers, you are out. You will vanish from this earth. Don't even try me. This one is your own. You do not have a choice. Useless man.
Look at this woman. It's pregnancy by force. How can a married woman be pregnant for me? For what?
Leave my trouser alone.
I will not. We must appear to the board like this.
You don't know when I am serious. I am capable of doing worse things than you think of. Let's go off my trouser.
You cannot do anything. We are going like this to meet the end. You see that which we did in the hidden will come to light. See, you don't know who you are messing with. You don't know me. You don't know me. Hey. You don't know me. You don't know me.
Can we do this outside? Can we do this? Hey.
Don't you do me
will cut it. You see this thing where you want to want it? You see this thing where you want to want it? You know that's not the only person in this office. This is just...
Okay, listen to me. Listen to me. Okay. Sir, you're already making noise.
What is happening here? He got me pregnant. There's what?
She's writing a report here. And I saw the report, and at the same time, she's then walking.
He got me pregnant, and he was marrying me.
Yes.
It's a joke. It's a joke. It's a joke. It's a joke.
Who is joking with you?
Tell her you're joking. Stop this! It's a joke, yo. It's a joke. I will explain to you later. It's a joke.
Madam, where are you going to? I know you came here to tell him that you are pregnant for him. So just say it.
She knows I'm pregnant? Indeed, pregnancy cannot be hidden.
There was something you said about her. Is she pregnant?
Your hand work. You've been a very, very bad boy.
If she's pregnant, that means the pregnancy belongs to someone else.
How is that my business?
Well, that means the pregnancy is for Jeffrey, the manager.
How is that my business?
No, I know what I'm saying.
I'm talking about my own. You must marry me. Come, let's go and see the end.
Okay, so. I'm begging you, just give me some time. Let me just relax myself. When I get home, I'll call you this evening. Please.
No.
I promise I'll call
you. No. You must marry me.
We'll
go and see the end.
We'll sort this out.
Let's go and see the end. Leave me alone. Let's go.
See, I don't even know what to do. Bianca, think. Delay is dangerous. What am I going to do?
Called me.
Yes, I did.
Say whatever I have to say. I need to take my pregnant wife to the hospital for checkup.
Wife? Pregnant wife? But you told me that you aren't married.
I don't understand why you're wasting my time. If there's anything you need to say, please say it. I'm in a hurry. I need to leave this place.
I came to let you know that I'm pregnant for you. Ha 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 ha!
You see, you know that song, that popular song, last, last, it don't cast, and everybody go chop breakfast.
Shayo, so let me drop this. A minute, I'm coming.
You see, little girls are allowing themselves to be put in family ways and not you. Just look at you. As old as you are, you're not even ashamed of yourself. You are exposed, you're learned. Why would you then allow yourself to be put in family way? Does it make sense? Ain't you even ashamed of yourself saying that to me?
Is that all you have to say?
Mm-mm. I should scream. All right, I should celebrate you for bringing such news to me. My friend, respect yourself. Anyway, a quick advice. Can you take that pregnancy to your husband? Because that's the father of the child.
I will not take another man's pregnancy to my husband. He is not responsible for it. And we've not made love in a very long time.
Well, that's none of my business though, but... like I said, you need to do the needful by taking the pregnancy to the man.
If you like, get all the girls pregnant in the whole world. I do not care. You should know what we have to do.
You and who? I'm asking you. You and who? Well, I've advised you to take the pregnancy to the rightful owner. You said you wouldn't do that. Well, I want to advise you before Gungo kill your papa. Before I murder her, go fight into your left ear. Listen, I don't know you and you don't know me. And I don't want to ever see you around my office again. Do I make myself clear? Get off. If you don't leave that place, I'm going to run you through with my car. And you trust me.
You have not heard the last of me, definitely.
Our hearts filled with greed and wickedness. She cares only for herself. And do whatever she please with recklessness. She lies, she cheats, and hurts anyone that stands in her way. But in the end, there'll always be a price to pay.
Oh, the just woman, her heart straight and steady, her light shines so bright. She's always ready to stand for justice and lend a helping hand. She's truly grand, a Oriche Kobo. She's a just woman, Oporiche Kobo. How you lay your bed is how you lie on it. What you sow is what you reap. How you lay your bed is how you lie on it. What you sow is what.
Baby, no, baby. Why are you moving my hand?
Becca, what is it now? Please, allow me to have some sleep. Please.
No, I'm horny for you. Don't make love to me, no.
Becca, what is it now? What is it? Make love with who? You call me a 1 minute man, and you want the 1 minute man to make love to you?
Baby, but you've always wanted me now. Take me for the night. You have me for the night. I'm your wife.
Oh, Bianca. Bianca. You want to try me? Eh? You want to try me? It will not work for you. I know you are a drama queen. Eh? But just go and tell them that you did not see me at home. Bianca, you did not see me at home at all. Okay?
Filled with greed and wickedness, she cares only for herself and do whatever she please with recklessness. She lies, she cheats,
and hurts anyone that stands in her way. But in the end, there'll always be a price to pay.
Oh, the just woman, her heart straight and steady, her light shines so bright.
Some people are just shameless. Can't imagine what's going on in the office. Nene and Bianca are pregnant.
It's unbelievable. At least they can rest now.
The funny thing is, the people responsible are denying it. The manager is saying he isn't the one. So is the supervisor.
I'm equally not the one. Yeah.
Well, the Bible says that righteousness exalts as a nation.
Enough of all of that. Can we talk about us, please?
Yes, boss. Sorry.
So I've been meaning to say this to you. I want us to meet my parents. Yeah, what do you think? Yeah, I mean, I want them to get to know you and all of that. Would you like that?
Are you sure this is what you want?
Yeah. Listen, you've proven to me that you're quite different from every other person, you know? So I'd like us to take this entire relationship really serious.
What makes you think I'm different?
Let me worry about that.
You would not believe what I'm about to tell you.
Anne, what is it? What is that?
What is going on in our office is unheard of. Can you imagine? Mrs. Bianca and Nini are pregnant.
Pregnant? How? Who? I don't get it.
Mom, the news is everywhere in the office. And people are saying that the manager and the supervisor are responsible for their pregnancies.
Akosipona! What abomination! Responsible for their pregnancy? Huh. What type of story is this?
At least, Mrs. Bianca got what she always wanted.
My daughter, wait. What are the management saying about this? What are they saying about this?
I think not the same ones who are responsible for this messy situation.
Okay. Chief Richard, what is he doing about?
Good morning. I don't think he has any idea. He doesn't know what is going on.
Akosikwana. You mean Chief Richard does not know what is going on in that office?
According to his PA, the man doesn't have any idea. And talking about his PA, Oscar asked me out.
Eh? Say it again, I did not hear you well.
More. I said he asked me out.
And what was your reaction? What's your response?
Well, Mom, he also said he wants to go introduce me to his parents officially.
Akosipona! You mean taking you to his parents? Talk to me. So, when he take you to the parents, what will you do? What are you going to say?
Mom.
Eh? Answer me now, Kaimeriaza.
Why are you putting the horse in front of the cart? When I get to that bridge, I'll definitely cross.
Oh,
Ugamu. I know you will cross it now. And I go back. I think I like that guy.
Mom.
Eh?
Did you just say guy?
Guy.
You said that he's in the one.
Your guy. Not guy.
I can't even believe this. I don't have the head for this. What did you cook?
I'm hungry.
Go to the kitchen and dish food for yourself.
Thank you,
Mom. I love
How was your day?
But at least now, small time, I'll eat what I want. Go to the market. Your baby need you.
Mom, Dad, I have something really important I'd like to share with you. For a while, I've been meaning to tell you this. That I have finally found the woman I would love to spend the rest of my life with.
Oscar.
Dad.
What arrant nonsense are you spewing from your mouth?
Dad, what do you mean? Dad.
Dad, me here. Your mom and I have our eyes fixated on a particular girl. A well brought up girl that we want you to get married to. And here you are telling us that you found some girl somewhere that you want to marry and you expect us to approve of her? No.
But Dad, I'm trying to understand what you mean. Mom, is that true? No, the question should have been, how come no one mentioned that to me?
Son, it's true we didn't tell you. But this particular girl is a girl we have known and watched for good 7 years. She's a very good girl and a good wife material. She's the best for you.
Mom, I love you so much and I know you want the best for me. Well, Mom, the truth is, I don't know who you want me to be with, and I've never met her before, and I don't want to meet her. However, Mom, if you see the girl I want to be with, you're going to fall in love with her automatically. Trust me. She's an amazing person.
Oscar.
Dad.
With the level of atrocity taking place in our company, I don't want you to end up marrying just any girl. Okay?
Atrocities. Dad, wait. Dad, are you aware of what happens in our company?
Oscar, it might interest you to know that I installed CCTV system in that company with hidden cameras in all the offices and the factory itself.
Dad.
Yes. I see everything. I know everything. The reason I kept quiet and refused to act on those things I've been saying is because there is a particular girl among the staff that I have my eyes on. And that is the girl I want you to get married to.
Dad, you're trying to get me confused. Wait. Dad, if I heard you correctly, did you say the girl you want me to get married to?
You want me to get married to one of our staff?
Look, from the very first day I set my eyes on that girl, I told myself, this is my daughter-in-law.
Son.
Mom.
I want you to get married to Sharon Obidi. She's the best for me. That is my daughter-in-law.
What?
Yes.
What's funny? Oh my world. This is not happening. Mom. I was about to tell you about Sharon.
That's...
We're on the same page. I mean, she's the one I'm talking about.
It's a lie. What? It's a lie.
What the heck? What? Wait. How come?
No, did you just see me the way I pressed down?
What the hell? But, by the way, that did you say you know what happens in our company?
Forget about that one. Give me a handshake.
Dad.
You're my son.
Dad, but wait a second. You mean you've been seeing everything happening in the company?
Of course, yes.
So I have good news and I can't wait to spill it.
What good news?
My parents, Chief Richards and Justice Morin, they have accepted for us to be together.
Chief Richards.
Yes.
Chief Richards of Richmond Group of Company, as in my boss, is your father.
Yes, he's my father. We've been working together for a while now.
But why did you hide your identity from me? Why is that supposed to make me feel?
It's a long story. I apologize, but I'll tell you a lot of things about me that you don't know. I have a lot of things to tell you about myself and my family. A lot of things, yes. But moving forward, my father said it is time to take our company to the next level. And you're not exempted. You're going to be part of it. So I'm here to take you to work. Yeah.
Wait, you know, I'm going to get you to work. Let me repeat this question.
You mean Chief Richard of Richmore Group of Company? Your father?
I welcome all of you to today's staff meeting. We've been having staff meetings, but this one is a peculiar one, a special one. Without much ado, let me introduce a special someone to you. Oscar, please stand.
Thank you, Chief.
May I introduce to you Barrister Oscar Chukwuebuka Richard, from the surname, you must have realized that is my son. He is going to be your new managing director. Well, I will be retiring very soon, and he is taking over from me as the new managing director of Richmore Group of Companies.
Right.
Right? Oscar, you're welcome.
Thank you, Dad.
Oscar?
Yes, Dad.
You may address your staff.
Thank you, Dad. Hi, everyone. I can read your mind. Everyone is surprised.
Like my father rightly said, I'm Barrister Oscar. Yeah, I know. You're surprised. First of all, I would like to commend my father for his hard work, for running this company for over 30 years. Or should I say, for successfully running this company for over 30 years. My father is a great man. A great husband to my mother.
Thank you.
A great father to me. And a great boss to everyone. Dad, I must thank you for giving me the opportunity to learn, to acquire knowledge overseas, and most importantly, to be your son. Thank you, Dad.
Welcome, son.
After law school, I wanted to practice, but my father said no. I am retiring, son. I need you to run the company. And I said, how, Dad? I'm inexperienced. I don't know what you do here, and how do I run the company? And my father said to me, you have to start from somewhere. I said, okay, where do I start from? He said, come be the GM. I said, how do I become the GM when I don't have the experience? He said, you have to start from somewhere. I said, how, Dad? He said, I have an idea. And I said, what's the idea? He said, come work as a PA. And I can tell you've been seeing me signing checks, going on errands, carrying my father's briefcase, driving him everywhere. And this is my point. During my time working as a PA, I was sensitive enough to observe a lot of things. Lack of work ethics, lack of character, stupidity, no control, no integrity. Mr. Edmund.
What are you laughing at?
Arrested for
you
what?
Tried to poison my dad. You tried to kill my dad. You gave him an eye drop. And you poisoned it. How dare you?
You wanted to take over the company.
It's the handbook of the devil. I didn't mean to poison your father. It's the devil's handbook.
I can see some of you are pregnant. Thanks to Mr. Edmund and Mr. Jeffrey, who's on the run. But can I surprise you? My father has hidden cameras in his office. He knows about everything, but he pretended not to know. Are you happy now? You should be ashamed of yourself. God used Sharon to change a lot of things. God used her to save my father's life. God used her to save this company from drowning. You wanted to drown this company, Mr. Edmund. We saw you. We saw everything you were doing. This company is my father's hard work for over 30 years. And there you go. You want to ruin the company? You want to ruin our image? Do you know how long we have worked hard to get to this level? Like I said, you should be arrested. And I leave that to my father. To cut a long story short, Sharon is the new general manager here.
I got married last week. And you're all invited to my wife's wedding. It takes place next Saturday. Thank you. God bless you.
Thank you, Oscar. And one last thing. One last thing. Like Oscar said, a lot of atrocity went down in the company, which we saw via our hidden CCTV cameras. Now, for all those who were involved in these atrocities, that includes Edmund, his two pregnant women here, and the others, you are all fired. Stop that. Tomorrow, the new recruits to replace those of you that are fired will resume work. For those of you remaining, I want to thank you for your steadfastness and I wish you success as you work with my son, Oscar.
Thank you.
Thank you.
People are very strange. Mr. Edmund, can you be civil and kindly sit down? Thank you.
So as I was saying before, he rudely interrupted me. The new recruits will resume.
They are always planning, always plotting,
so
manipulating.
I wish you all success.
Because of their selfish needs. Hey,
Oscar.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Mr. Udefuna. Your daughter is pregnant, and I'm not responsible for her pregnancy. Oh, what is it that you do not understand? I say your daughter is pregnant. She has been sleeping with her colleagues in the office. And she think, I don't know. I know of it, but I kept quiet. Because I know the day like this will come. Oh, please, you can call your daughter and hear from the horse's mouth. Because your daughter will leave my house today. Oh, God, if you come here to pick your daughter, I will return your daughter back to you in court. Yes. Woman, listen. Pack your things and leave my house right now.
I thought you said you love me. I thought you said you can take bullets for me. So you could not cover my shame.
Cover your shame? Your shame? Please, carry your shame and go. Please pack your things and leave my house. My home. Please leave. Me, carry your shame. I will leave my house.
She's just a woman.
I still leave my house. Pack your things and leave. I said, leave my house!
Is how you lie in it.
I said, leave my house right now.
What you sow is what you
leave.
How you lay your bed is how you lie on it. What you sow is what you reap.
Woman, heart straight and steady, light shines so bright. She's always ready to stand for justice and lend a helping hand. She's truly great. Oh, reaching call.